ESPN's Chick-fil-A kickoff game is presented by Hampton Hotels. Alabama won the toss and deferred, so Virginia Tech will receive the opening kickoff. Cade Foster to kick it away. Senior from Southlake, Texas, who's been their kickoff man for the last 3 years, blessed with a strong leg. Two of the fastest players on the Virginia Tech team are back deep, Chris Mangus and Dimitri Knowles. And for the Tide and Hokies, this season is underway. Returnable as it comes down to Knowles, sophomore out of the Bahamas, and he was chopped up short of the 20 by D. Hart. Logan Thomas is the Virginia Tech quarterback. Big 6'6", listed at 260. He told us last night he's a little bit under that. And one of the challenges this year, Chris, to be more accurate, that 51% among the worst in the country. Frank Beamer says he got too much of the blame last year. They couldn't run the ball, so they were constantly in 2nd and 10, 3rd and 10, and it's hard to complete a high percentage. Trey Edmonds is the running back. They fake it to him. It's a pitch out to DJ Coles, and he smothered the line of scrimmage. Trying to trick Ha-Ha Clinton Dix, one of the best safeties in the country, and it didn't work.
One of the things you'll find with this defense of Alabama, that it's very disciplined. That's what I was talking about in the open. They do not make mental mistakes, so it's very difficult to try to catch them off guard or out of position. Witness the first play.
Alabama defense last year, number one in the nation in scoring defense, gave up fewer than 11 points per game. They also led the nation in rushing defense, total defense. Here's one of those 2nd and 10s, and the pass through the hands of his intended receiver, DJ Coles. 3rd down and 10. The Hokie offense that really struggled last year, scored 25 points per game. That was 81st in the country. They were in the top 20 in the nation last year when the season began, but had to win their last 3 games to finish with a winning record at 7 and 6.
This is where they've been in trouble last year, the 3rd and long situations. You don't want to be in that too many times against this aggressive defense.
Option, Thomas pitched it to DJ Coles, coming back after missing last year with a knee injury. John Fulton, the corner, the first to stack him up, along with CJ Mosley, their leading tackler from a year ago, who opted not to go to the NFL. And that was great news in Tuscaloosa. Not the kind of start the Hokies had hoped for. And A.J. Hughes, the left-footed punter, is on to kick, because they were so bad on offense last year. He kicked 79 times. Christian Jones back forward, waiting at his own 38-yard line. Line drive kick all the way back to the 29. Jones, a junior, whips some room. Christian Jones. There are no flags. Touchdown, Alabama. The first time they touched the ball, they score. Cade Foster for the extra point after a 72-yard punt return for a touchdown by Christian Jones. It was a 55-yard punt only a minute and 39 seconds into the season. Alabama, if you can dominate for a minute and 39 seconds, the Tide have. Two-time defending national champion, the Alabama Crimson Tide, off to an electrifying start about 3.5 hours from their campus
in Tuscaloosa. Christian Jones, his first career punt return for a touchdown. He brought a kickoff back for a score last year against Ole Miss. 7-0. The offense hasn't been on the field yet for Bama. And Cade Foster will kick off for the second time. Again, it's Chris Mangus and Dimitri Knowles back deep. Knowles again from the two. And again, he won't reach the 20-yard line. Chased out by Ha-Ha Clinton Dix, one of the starting safeties on kickoff coverage.
Let's take a look at this return, Sean. Two things stand out. First of all, discipline, not to block in the back or create a penalty or not block behind the runner. The other thing, superior athletic ability. That's what we're seeing. If you go down the roster, especially the skill positions of Alabama, Scott Nussmeier, the offensive coordinator, told Doug Nussmeier, the offensive coordinator, told us explosive, 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 and Christian Jones fell on that list.
And we have explosive playmakers everywhere. Virginia Tech needs to find some. Thomas throws quickly. And Clinton Dix up again to smother Dimitri Knowles at the line of scrimmage. Here's a look at tonight's impact players brought to you by Chick-fil-A. They're hoping Edmonds can emerge. They didn't have a running back rush for 500 yards last year. Knowles could be a deep threat.
And also Jack Tyler on the defensive side of the ball. Very instinctive. Should make a lot of plays tonight for the Hokies.
Four plays from scrimmage, all for no gain for the Hokies. Bunch formation. Thomas was their leading rusher last year, at least gained a yard that time before he was pulled down by Ed Stinson. Part of the front three defensively, senior from Homestead, Florida.
One thing off the get-go that we're noticing about the Crimson Tide defense is their ability to gang tackle. That's not a sometimes thing with them, it's an all-the-time thing. Everybody preaches it, but not everybody does it in the game. Put on the film, they do it all day.
Kirby Smart is the defensive coordinator. In his sixth year leading the defense. In his seventh year on the staff, movement at the right end of the offensive line. Lawrence Gibson, another first-time starter at tackle.
63 offense, 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
Bill Lemonnier of the Big Ten, leading the officiating crew in this non-conference game. Frank Beamer was concerned about playing this game against this team with two tackles who have never started a game before on offense, including a true freshman at left tackle, Jonathan McLaughlin, first left tackle ever to start any game as a true freshman for Frank Beamer. On third and 14, Thomas has his man, a big gain to DJ Coles. It would certainly help Virginia Tech if he could have a big year coming back from a knee injury. That's a 34-yard gain. Fulton and Clinton Dix made the tackle.
And look at his footwork, Sean. Feet and shoulders are square to the target, so he's able to deliver a strike. And I like what Virginia Tech here, going a little hurry up to catch Alabama off guard.
From the 47, play action pass. Thomas threw it away. Looking for Juan Perez Means, the tight end who's starting. They're without Ryan due to injury. But even in some ways, Chris, that's a good sign for Virginia Tech, because Frank Beamer said last year when they really struggled on offense, Thomas tried to put more and more on his own shoulders. Reason he threw 16 interceptions, tried to force it in too many times.
Yeah, and I think there, Sean, what you're going to see is that's a confidence builder for the big fella number three, Logan Thomas.
Very warm inside this dome. It's a warm and humid evening outside. Thomas throwing deep, single coverage, some pushing and shoving as Knowles was covered by Dion Blue. Blue was a given at one corner. The other corner was a question mark as they tried to replace D. Milner, drafted by the Jets in the first round.
See right there, good footwork and pressure. What I like about Alabama's corners is they'll get up and they play bump and run. They play bump and run. They make sure they get their hands on the receiver to disrupt the timing of the route. Outstanding coverage, well coached. Should be. Nick Saban coaches those guys.
Another third down and 10. Five-man rush. And the pass is dropped by Dimitri Knowles. Hit immediately by Jarek Williams. Secondary a question mark for Alabama. But as is the case all over their team, Chris, a lot of talent, just figuring out who's going to play where more than anything else.
You know, that's what I think it also set Alabama's defense apart over the years, is that they're always so strong in the back end. In today's day and age of passing the football all over the place, that's where their strength is on the defensive side.
And Christian Jones back for another punt from A.J. Hughes. The officials very close to the corner, but Hughes didn't quite pin them in deep. 53-yard punt. It'll come out to the 20-yard line. We'll see the Alabama often 50,000 people for it this weekend. Parade was this morning.
Yeah, Wonder Twins powers activate. And they were doing that this morning.
A.J. McCarron trying to activate his powers as he hands it off to T.J. Yeldon. Sophomore ahead for two. A.J. McCarron trying to lead Alabama to a third straight national championship. How about that touchdown to interception ratio? Last year he threw a single season record 30 touchdown passes for Bama. Only three interceptions.
Plays with a little chip on his shoulder, doesn't he, Sean?
Mm-hmm.
He thinks everybody's counting him out this year. We only have 58 out of 60 first place votes.
Said to us the other day, we're out to prove all the doubters wrong. Who are the doubters? A.J. McCarron fires right on target and inbounds. Amari Cooper, his first catch of the season. Good for 18 yards for the sophomore.
Yeah, timing is the key. This ball is delivered before Amari's out of his cut. And the thing we talked about with A.J. McCarron, passes of 20 yards or more, over 65%, very accurate down the field.
A lot of times it's easy because the opponents stack up on the run. That play action game so effective for Alabama.
Hokie
defense crowding the line of scrimmage. The lone back is T.J. Yeldon. And the back shoulder throw did not connect with Cooper, who set the freshman record last year for Alabama, broke Julio Jones's mark when he caught 59 balls for 1,000 yards. Both are freshman receiving records at Alabama. He really came out at the end of the year, four 100-yard receiving games in their last five.
The thing I like about him is a young guy, excellent at running routes. That was a good pass right there. That's a rare drop you'll see from Amari Cooper.
Second and 10. Flag down. Yeldon ahead for about three. Tyshawn Jarrett, the safety, made the tackle.
You know, Sean, the one thing that Bud Foster is going to do is he's always going to bring five. That's pressure. And when you do that, sometimes you're vulnerable in the back end. So I'm looking for Alabama.
Offside. Defense. Number 92. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
To take a shot deep down the middle of the field soon, especially right around here in midfield. It's a good place to try it. Second and five, setting up well for it.
Saw Bud Foster, the longtime defensive coordinator for the Hokies. And one of the very best in the business. Out of the pistol, Yeldon in trouble behind the line of scrimmage, broke some tackles, delivered a stiff arm, and almost got the first down. Bud Foster told us last night we're not going to be able to tackle him with one man, and they weren't able to. And Kyle Fuller is injured on the play. That would be a huge loss. He got the worst of his collision with the powerfully built Yeldon at 6'2", 218 pounds.
You're right. You can't afford to lose your best cover guy against. And I think he just got the quote unquote bell rung a little bit. And Bud Foster told us when we tackle T.J. Yeldon, we got to blow his tires. That means come in low. Now, when you do that, you have to make sure you wrap up and not make contact with the crown of your helmet, because you will get injured, because that's a hard part of the body to hit. Watch here, Sean. This is exactly what they're trying to do, and you see his head get knocked to the side. And to his credit, he's like a fighter. He's trying to get up and just got knocked out a little bit. But you want to try to avoid your head on contact and hit the legs or the lower part of the legs with the shoulder pads and wrap those arms.
The good news is Fuller is back on his feet. One of four Fuller brothers from Baltimore to play for Frank Beamer. He's been joined on the team this year by his brother Kendall Fuller, who's starting in the secondary alongside Kyle as a true freshman. He's one of the top rated recruits in the history of Virginia Tech football, wearing number 11
right there on your screen.
Charleston Fowler has come in to the backfield trying to lead the way for Yeldon, who's blown up by Jack Tyler. They're all ACC linebacker.
Well, this is what you're going to live with, the pressure. Now, Jack Tyler's hitting it on a snap. And what I love about that, when you see a linebacker not give one for one, that means take on a blocker and just say, I did my job. No, he defeats the blocker and is able to finish the play with a tackle for loss.
The loss of four. And the Hokie defense holds. It looks like Virginia Tech is settling in a bit after that stunning start when Christian Jones returned a punt for a touchdown. Frank Beamer and the Hokies made their name over the years largely on Beamer ball, the outstanding play of the special teams, but in recent years even that has fallen off. Chick-fil-A kickoff game. The Chick-fil-A Bowl also played in this building. Cody Mandel on the punt. Willie Byrne back deep for Virginia Tech. And a fair catch signaled by Byrne at the 15. Here's Shannon Spake.
Well, Sean, when we spoke with Logan Thomas last night, he said he worked on mechanics in the offseason. He has also worked on being a better leader for his guys, and that was completely evident when he was just on the bench. He was very loose. He was smiling. He kept a smile on his face, trying to get the fans into the game. He also walked up and down his line. Gave everyone a little bit of love, gave a little extra love to Jonathan McLaughlin. Of course, that's a left tackle, true freshman, but you can really see him leading down here.
Said most of all, he needed to learn how to get in guys' faces. He said he tended to be sensitive himself, didn't feel comfortable getting after some of his teammates. Feels much more comfortable doing that now as a senior. He isn't going to accept another 7-6 year. Trey Edmonds straight ahead. The son of Farrell Edmonds, the former Pro Bowl tight end of the National Football League. C.J. Mosley and Vinny Sunseri made the tackle. Seven of their 10 plays for no yards. They did have the one big pass play that probably gave everybody on the Virginia Tech sideline a lift with as bad as it had been to that point. Straight ahead across the 20 and into Trey DePriest, one of the inside linebackers in that 3-4 defense for Nick Saban.
Hey Sean, I want to go back to the leadership of Logan Thomas. And yeah, it's okay to get in guys' face, but there's two parts to that. In order to get in guys' face credibility, you have to be able to produce on a consistent basis, and that's what he needs to do this year. And the other thing is, when you knock a guy down, you better be the first one there to pick him up. That's leadership.
Well, he's a very impressive young man. He's already graduated, did so back in December with a degree in human development, working toward another degree in psychology. Third down and four. More than chances Dimitri Knowles has had to be a playmaker.
They had the perfect play on too. They had a bunch formation and a closed wide receiver to the single receiver side, and everybody does crossing routes because they knew Alabama was going to be in man to man. A chance, if you want to beat Alabama, you have to convert. That's an easy catch to make.
Here's Hughes for the third time already. Christian Jones provided the only score of this game. If you're just joining us, minute 39 into the game, a 72-yard punt return for the Alabama touchdown. That's how bad their bowl game was. The Hokies, Russell Athletic Bowl in Atlanta against Rutgers. They won 13-10. Hughes, the punter, should have been the MVP. Did a great job punting 11 times. And if another DVD exists of that bowl game, it should be destroyed.
Offense, number 27, 5-yard penalty, remains fourth down.
I made myself watch it because it was the last game Virginia Tech played, and the Hokies didn't even have 200 yards of offense. Somehow managed to win. Antoine Exum had a big interception late to set up a score for Frank Beamer. They're without Exum, one of their best defensive backs. Hoping he'll be back about a month into the season, rehabbing from a knee injury suffered in January in a pickup basketball game.
Yeah, it's a tough loss. I hope they don't kick it to Christian right here. Yeah, kick it away from me.
I'd like it a little longer than that, though. Jones runs up to make a fair catch, high and short. The kick by A.J. Hughes, just 33 yards. Festive weekend in a home this weekend, playing the Miami Marlins. NASCAR's in town. At the Atlanta Motor Speedway, a little bit south of here. And Chris's favorite, the Dragon Con Parade.
Shazam.
From the 49, a play fake by McCarron. It is he threw and dumped it off incomplete for T.J. Yeldon. Well defended all the way around by Virginia Tech. Tariq Edwards had the tight coverage after Luther Maddie had his arms around A.J. McCarron.
Well, nice job by Virginia Tech applying the pressure. They're getting a little bit more comfortable, and they're getting in the face of the Alabama wide receivers. They wanted to go deep like we thought they would, but Virginia Tech's able to match up, and they're playing their safety about 20 yards back. So they definitely have deep help in the middle.
McCarron 25-2 in his career as the starting quarterback. Has as many national championship rings as he has career losses as a starter. Short over the middle, the Andrew White. Run down in space. Good work by Donovan Riley, who's a backup defender. Kyle Fuller not on the field right now after he got the bad end of that collision earlier with T.J. Yeldon. There's Kendall Fuller, his true freshman brother.
Tech defense has 9 returning starters, Sean, and they knew that was the strength. And playing a team like Alabama early in the season, they got to be able to carry you.
Frank Beamer says we have an excellent defense. We have an outstanding quarterback. We have good kickers. That's a very good place to start. Now we need the rest of the team to fill in around those strengths. Third down and 8. 6 minutes to go in the quarter. McCarron on the run. Is he inbounds? Yes, for the first down. Kevin Norwood. Kendall Fuller had the coverage. They get 11 on third down and 8.
New aspect to his game. I was talking to some pro scouts early in the work. One thing they wanted to see from A.J. McCarron is this, the ability to throw on a run. His eyes staying downfield. Norwood does a good job of understanding where he is on the field. The thing I loved about it, he caught the ball with his hands and not belly catch.
Doug Nussmeier saying Norwood's a very precise route runner as well. Caught 29 balls last year. Yeldon ahead to the 34. Chris, of course, the big story for Alabama, replacing 3 outstanding offensive linemen. They had an NFL caliber offensive line last year. But 3 new starters this year. The returning starters are Anthony Steen, the right guard, and Cyrus Kwanjo, the left tackle. How do you think they fared so far?
I think they're doing okay. In a preseason scrimmage a couple weeks ago, they struggled. Coach Saban called them out. And they'll get better as the year goes on and they start playing together. It should be like fingers in a glove.
Ryan Kelly takes over for the great Barrett Jones at center. McCarron on target. Amari Cooper weaving through traffic and down inside the 20. Brandon Faison, another true freshman in that Virginia Tech secondary, made the tackle after a pickup of 15.
Okay, they're going to pick on number 2 right there for Virginia Tech. Donovan Riley with a little bit of a pick. He had Yellen go outside. He rubbed a defender, which cleared Amari Cooper, getting in Donovan Riley's pass to cover and close on Cooper. And again, the ball is on time and on target, which allows Cooper to run after catch.
Hokies really could not afford an injury to Kyle Fuller, senior defender, surrounded by youth in that secondary, particularly without Exum, who would be a senior. McCarron, deep corner ball up for grabs and out of bounds. Cooper looked like he came away with it with Kendall Fuller in good coverage. But by the time he grasped it, he was across the boundary.
Now AJ has no trouble throwing jump balls, especially to Amari Cooper. And look at the true freshman, Kendall Fuller, going up and battling Amari Cooper. You see the strong hands on Cooper, even though he was out of bounds and incomplete.
Still crowd saw the same replay we saw. Some of the Bama fans wondering if there might be a replay review by Tom Herbert. Would you say the crowd's about 60-40 Alabama? Neutral game. The tickets were split. It's a little closer to Tuscaloosa. Seems to be a bit more crimson in the building.
Agreed.
Yeldon dancing down to the 10. Tariq Edwards the stop. It'll be third and one. Here's Shannon.
Team is saying Kyle Fuller is clear to return. He was just complaining that his helmet kind of came down funny on his head, kind of pushed forward on his face. But Virginia Tech actually has a computer, a wireless system, 12 sensors in each of the helmets that reads the impact of the helmet. So they took a look at that and they have cleared Kyle Fuller to return to the game.
Yeah, you understand that the precautions taken for the protection of the player, and especially now the awareness of head injuries, you want to make sure he's absolutely ready to come in and healthy.
Third down and one. They go up the middle with Yeldon. Bounced it to the right and picked up the first down with a yard and a half to spare. Luther Maddy and James Gale made the tackle. The front four of that Virginia Tech defense is the strength, particularly Gale. They're glad he came back for his senior year, one of the best defensive ends in the ACC.
The problem they have is they don't have a lot of depth. And Sean, you asked me the question earlier, how's the Alabama offensive line faring? Right there, very well. Third and one, and you can change the line of scrimmage and push the defenders back like they did. That's a win for the big fellas in the crimson.
First and goal, Alabama. Under 3.5 to go in the first quarter. They lead 7-0. Another play fake by McCarron. All kinds of time. And over the head of Cooper. Give Fuller credit. And Frank Beamer and Bud Foster aren't surprised that he's holding his own. There is a flag on the play. You see right in the middle of the field. They talk about, look at how many freshmen make an impact all over college football. Why can't
Holding.
Fuller?
71 offense. 10-yard penalty. Be first down.
Cyrus Kwanjo, considered one of the top offensive line prospects in the country, a junior. Already speculation about whether he'll be back for his senior year. He's almost certain to be a first round pick if he comes out at the end of this year.
Just going back to Fuller, you know, like an Alabama recruit, he had a lot of those stars by his name. I think he had five of them. I'm not sure Virginia Tech gets a lot of five star guys, but he's one and he's shown it today.
He's the most decorated recruit they've ever had. Tyrod Taylor was the last five star recruit they had, the fine quarterback. First and goal now. They're back at the 17. Bringing with their first offensive touchdown of the year. Lots of room in the flat. Christian Jones, who scored on the punt return, gets them back to the 9-yard line. Chopped down by Dietrich Bonner, the safety.
Now this is on the defense number 24 you see for Virginia Tech. Not playing man-to-man. Tyreek Edwards got lost in a run fake. And anytime you're playing man-to-man coverage, which they wore, you got to disregard any run fakes and stay with your guy. As Christian Jones came across, he got lost in the shuffle. Big yardage for Alabama.
Second and goal from just inside the 9. Yeldon up the middle. Jack Tyler stopped him near the 2-yard line.
Sean, last year, yards after contact for Yeldon, about 2.6 yards. You see Jack Tyler, who's a good, solid tackler, hit him low, but the strength of Yeldon carried him about 2.6 yards.
Per carry. Well, that's average for every time he carried the ball. Yeah. He got over 2 yards after contact. Backed up Eddie Lacy last year, ran for more than 1,300. Yeldon rushed for 1108, the Alabama freshman record.
On balance line right here, they got big Cyrus on the right side as a tight end.
on third and goal. Yeldon powers his way into the end zone.
This is a dead giveaway. You're going to put your best offensive lineman as a tight end, and eventually the ball carrier will work his way, and you'll see the collapse of the Virginia Tech defense led by Cyrus Quandjo right there, just to push a double team, keep driving, keep driving, keep driving, and you have a running back with power like Yeldon. Easy play for the Crimson Tide. Well executed.
Cade Foster adds the extra point. Alabama goes 49 yards, took them 5 minutes to do it, 11 plays, capped by the run by Yeldon. It's 14. Well, a good start. Not an easy opponent to begin for Bielema. A big hole. Trey Edmonds off to the races. They will not catch him. He pulls away and scores 78 yards for the Hokies. Jurnell adds the extra point. Boy, did Virginia Tech need that.
So watch offensive tackle number 63, Gibson. Remember, a young player. Watch what he does. You want to talk about sustaining blocks, which opens a hole. See, drive that defender all the way across the ball. Then you have number 14. Trey Edmonds showing great speed, and it starts off with Logan Thomas too. That was a read option. Logan did a good job of reading where the defense was, saw the hole open up, made the decision to let Edmonds take it. You get a big play, but it started off by the sustained block from Gibson as an offensive tackle, a young guy making a big play for his teammates on the offensive line.
First career touchdown, his first college game. He redshirted last year. Worked on his strength and speed. Out of Danville, Virginia. So they scored just 16 seconds after the Alabama touchdown. Get back within seven. And they don't usually have to huddle up very often over there after giving up a big play. They don't give up many.
Look who's taking charge of the huddle. He signs his name to that defense now. Your defensive end, you can't get driven past the ball by an offensive tackle, and that's where the hole was created. Lost his cutback lane.
Mitchell Ludwig kicked off for the Hokies. Kevin Norwood started out and then decided the better decision was to down it. Well, Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week continues tonight. Another terrific matchup here on ESPN. SEC Big 12, number 12 LSU taking on 20th ranked TCU, presented by Hampton Hotels, tonight at 9 on ESPN. Also live on Watch ESPN.
And keep an eye, speaking of watching, on the two defensive tackles for Virginia Tech, Hopkins and Maddie. They don't have a lot of depth at that position, and the only problem with scoring was that they maybe scored too fast, because those big fellas are over 300 pounds apiece, number 92 and 98, and might need a little rest, but they're tough guys, and they know that their team is counting on them to stay in the ball game and finish.
Play clock down to four. They huddled by the sideline and ran right over the ball. A.J. McCarron handed it off. Dalston Fowler in trouble and buried back at the 20 by this inspired Virginia Tech defense. Derek Hopkins and Josh Trimble leading the way.
Penetration by Daddy Nicholas, and it helps a little bit when you don't get on block. Now he got there a little too excited and came out of control. But one thing Virginia Tech's been known for is pursuit to the football. That's what Bud Foster demands.
Kyle Fuller's back on the field for the Hokie secondary, and that helps the cause. Second and 15. McCarron pressured more than usual, and he's down for a loss. Back at the 18-yard line, Luther Maddy, junior out of Delray Beach, Florida. He's having his way with some of these new starting offensive linemen for Alabama. Three first-time starters on this offensive line. Nick Saban said he knows there's going to be some growing pains in the first game. There are always some communication mistakes. He said we've lost a lot of experience. We're replacing them with a lot of talent, but they don't have the benefit of experience.
I'm just impressed with their effort in this day and age of guys taking plays off. We're seeing 92 and 98 bringing it every single down.
And a conservative call on third down and 16. Tip of the cap by the Alabama coaches to this Virginia Tech defense as the handoff went to Fowler, who stopped well short of the first down at the 25-yard line. Virginia Tech right back in the game, and Alabama will punt when we go to the second quarter.
See big things from number 14 Trey Edmonds. I know that put a smile on his face.
Logan Thomas hands it off to Edmonds. He's ahead to the 35. John Fulton made the tackle, gain of three. Frank Beamer, in talking about Edmonds, said, hey, the last time we played in this game, we played Alabama in the Georgia Dome 2009. Bama won by 10. He said, but in that game, we played a couple of freshmen named Ryan Williams and J. Ron Hosley, who made their presence known immediately. And he was hoping Edmonds, Kendall Fuller, the kind of freshman talent that could do that tonight against this great Alabama team. So far, they have. Blitz. Thomas is picked off. Vinny Sunseri scores, and Alabama has scored on special teams, offense, and now defense.
In the open, we talked about intelligence. That play was the perfect example. Smartest defense in college football.
And the kind of mistake Logan Thomas cannot afford to make. Cade Foster for the extra point. And it's 21-7. Now another play that might be a game changer. Vinny Sunseri, 35-yard interception return for a touchdown. A crusher for Frank Beamer.
No, it's not Logan. It's right here, number 18, DJ Coles. Now, what you're going to see is DJ Coles will quit on a route. He hears footsteps, and he gets alligator arms. Then you put a smart football player like Sunseri in a robber position, the result is touchdown. That's not on Logan Thomas, as he's telling DJ Coles right there, and there's some leadership ability. Don't blame him. But I'd get over on that sideline and say, if you ever quit on a route again, I'm never thrown to you again.
Yeah, well, he talked about he needs to learn to get after some of his teammates. If there was ever a time to get after somebody, that was the time. What an awful effort by DJ Coles.
Got shy, a little bit shy going across the middle.
Adam Griffith kicks off. First career touchdown by Vinny Sunseri after his third career interception. Dimitri Knowles to the 20, and that's all. Taken down by Reggie Ragland. Here's Reese Davis.
Sean, time for the Taco Bell Live Moss moment, and Oklahoma State is living big time. Jeremy Smith goes in against Mississippi State. J.W. Walsh over 100 yards rushing. The story, Glenn Spencer's defense is throttling the Bulldogs. It's 21-3 in the fourth.
Oklahoma State team, many believe, the favorite to win the Big 12 this year. Logan Thomas after the play fake. Going deep, and Knowles is behind the defense and can't run under it. They had it, and they didn't connect.
Well, way, I love the call by Scott Leffler, the offensive coordinator, showing faith and trust in your quarterback. It's a well thrown ball, but again, when you're playing the number one team in the country, a team that's going for destiny, you got to be able to convert when you have an opportunity to convert.
Be John Fulton, who's one of those vying to be the regular cornerback opposite Deion Blue. Second and 10, Hokies from their own 21. Edmonds slithers ahead to the 25-yard line. After that disappointing 7-6 a year ago, Frank Beamer made some changes on his coaching staff, brought in Scott Leffler with his hand up against his headset there and the pencil. He was the offensive coordinator last year at Auburn. He knows how tough this Alabama defense can be. Last year, Auburn had just 163 yards of offense and a 49-0 loss against Alabama, one of the most lopsided games in the history of that great rivalry. Third and 6, four-man rush, and the pass is low. Tended again for DJ Coles. Frank Beamer and Scott Leff were looking for playmakers at wide receivers. So far, they have not been unearthed in this first half.
And take a look at Logan Thomas's footwork right here. He's not in balance. He's not able to get both feet going to the target or in alignment. And when your feet are not in line with your shoulders toward the target, you're going to get dirt balls just like that one. Now he had pressure around him, so his feet got tangled a little bit.
A.J. Hughes to punt. Christian Jones has a 72-yard punt return for a touchdown tonight. He is going the wrong way. Down at the 18-yard line, Matt Roth made the tackle. 51-yard punt, 61-3 the last 5 years. Out in the flat, Dawson Fowler tackled immediately by Kyshawn Jarrett. No gain on the play. Nick says every year is a new year. Just because you've done well in recent years doesn't mean it gets handed off. Every team has to earn it. And he was worried about complacency, but he said he thought a great barometer, Chris, was that when they do their conditioning tests in the fall, when they come back from the summer, this is the best conditioned Alabama team as a group that they've had since he's been there.
The best thing about Alabama, they don't compete against other teams. They compete against past Alabama teams. That's what their motivation.
Yeldon stuffed by Tariq Edwards. Well, this Virginia Tech defense has been terrific. It's 21-7, but Alabama has scored a special teams touchdown and a defensive touchdown.
Bud Foster, you talk about coaches that maybe a little bit underappreciated. The consistency of the job that he's done over the years is remarkable, and his kids play hard. And again, I'm going to emphasize how well their two inside players are playing, Luther Matty and Derek Hopkins, and they're not getting much of a break. That's effort. That's toughness. That's what I love to see from college football players.
Third down and 12. McCarron a lot of time, one-on-one, and broken up by Kyle Fuller. Outstanding defense to swat it away from Christian Jones.
Discipline. Discipline in coverage. Trusting your training. Trusting your technique. Keeping the left arm off the body, going with the right arm across the body to knock it away. That's how to play corner, Kyle.
Alabama's offense has just 77 yards. Cody Mandel to punt. Senior from Lafayette, Louisiana. Ooh, under duress. No flag thrown. Mandel did go down. They came after him. Did not attempt to field a punt. Landon Collins downs it at the 29. Tide fans groaning. They thought there should have been a flag for running into the punter. 55-yard punt under duress.
think it was his own guy, Sean. I think number 29, Maxwell, was the one that clipped him, not a Virginia Tech player.
Bill Lamagne is a veteran official. He was right there. He had the best view at it.
And he got the right view.
There's Logan Thomas. One time it seemed he might play tight end at Virginia Tech. Highly recruited basketball player out of high school, turned down some Division I scholarship offers to play football. He's ahead to the 31. How about the praise for Logan Thomas from C.J. Mosley when we chatted with the Alabama linebacker earlier in the week? He said, Thomas reminds me of Cam Newton. Talk about the size, the strength, the running ability.
Well, yeah, he reminds me of Cam Newton, except he's not as accurate, he's not as fast.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
so you're not buying the comparison.
No, I think he can be very, very good. I just haven't seen it on a consistent basis yet.
Still 10.5 minutes to go in the first half. Edmonds. Good run. Moved the pile out to the 37, almost the 38-yard line. It'll be third down, about a yard and a half. Trey DePriest, Xavier Dixon on the stop for Alabama.
Well, if you're offensive line coach Jeff Grimes with that young group up there, you'd love to see them change the line of scrimmage, blocks, and keep their feet moving. As Mark May would say, chop, 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 chop. That's what they did.
We have a veteran center in David Wang and Andrew Miller, the right guard, is the best of that front bunch, playing with two first-time starters at tackle, if you're just joining us. Under pressure, Thomas, incomplete. They came with pressure on third down and short, and it paid off.
Right there is C.J. Mosley, and again, I want to talk about the intelligence of the defense. C.J. Mosley vacates his zone and is able to close, understanding that his area is now safe and secure, so he can become a secondary pass rusher to force the overthrow by Logan Thomas.
There's Hughes from Terre Haute, Indiana. He didn't punt till his senior year in high school. Christian Jones back deep.
He's getting a workout today.
Get out there!
In the same high school as Steve Weatherford, the longtime NFL punter who taught A.J. how to punt at a camp he did back in Terre Haute. He became a good one quickly. 42-yard punt there. Timeout. Round out the top five. McCarron had to throw it away as he was about to get drilled. Good pressure on the blitz by Kyshawn Jarrett. Here's Reese.
Sean, the debut for freshman quarterback Christian Hackenberg of Penn State is going beautifully against Syracuse. Hackenberger, Geno Lewis, he's thrown for nearly 250 yards, two touchdowns longer than 50, 23-10 Nittany Lions in the fourth.
And Reese, just as we threw it to you, Bill Lamagne threw a flag, perhaps for intentional grounding.
There's no foul on the play for intentional grounding. Receiver number four was in the area. We have an incomplete pass, second down.
The only problem with that, receiver number four was blocking. So he really wasn't an intended receiver. And Alabama gets away. Now watch T.J. Yeldon. He's going to be there blocking. He's not involved in a route at all. There's no screen pass set up. It's intentional grounding.
Well, this offensive line clearly has some work to do. It was an impossibly high standard to live up to, at least right out of the chute. What they had last year, those three terrific linemen they lost. Yeldon taken down by J.R. Collins, shy of the 20.
With an assist from the 18-yard line. He had a hole right there. And that could be a little sign of fatigue when the 18-yard line's making the tackle.
When we talk about the players they lost, Barrett Jones is here. Winner of the Remington Trophy, is the best center in the country. Ryan Kelly, sophomore from Westchester, Ohio, his replacement. Of course, Kelly got a lot of practice time with the first unit. Jones was injured, you might recall, leading up to the national championship game against Notre Dame. McCarron steps in one and has a first down. in traffic to the 32-yard line, DeAndre White. And the coaches were raving about what a great preseason camp he had. They needed 10. They got 12.
And it starts with a pocket presence right there. A.J. McCarron trusting his offensive line. He knew he was under pressure last play. Feet settled, feet moving, in position to throw. And that's why he's so accurate, because feet and shoulders were pointing to the target. He told us, Sean, he watched a lot of film in the offseason of Tom Brady about the pocket presence and moving in the pocket.
Brady has the knack for that one little step in just the right direction to get the time he needs to make a good throw. Karen's a very accurate passer, 67% career best in Alabama history, and that one hit his receiver right in the number 9, and Amari Cooper dropped it with Kyle Fuller in coverage.
Now, one that Amari Cooper should not and probably in the future will not drop. But you'll see the great coverage by Fuller, number 17, not looking back at the quarterback until the last second, and maybe getting and disrupting the vision of Amari Cooper.
Yeldon on 2nd and 10. You can't tackle him with one man if you do it correctly. And Kyshawn Jarrett did, the junior safety from Tannersville, Pennsylvania. Only 22 yards rushing for Yeldon on 11 carries.
And here's the deal. They're putting more up in the box or the line of scrimmage than Alabama has the block. Now, how are you supposed to get away from that? Well, they're playing man-to-man on the edges, and you have to be able to beat their corners with your wide receivers to give the safeties out of there to help. They can't do that because the Virginia Tech corners are matching up very well with the Alabama receivers.
3rd down and 10, midway through the second quarter. Alabama leading 21-7. McCarron off his back foot, intercepted by Kyle Fuller. And he's down at the 35-yard line. DeAndre White was the intended receiver. Bruce Smith on the sideline for Virginia Tech. One of their all-time great players. Loves what he sees from the Hokie defense, which has been terrific here in the first half.
Well, I'm going to tell you what. Kyle Fuller ran a better route than the intended receiver, White, for Alabama. He broke on that in route before White broke on that in route. There's my former teammate, Bruce Smith, dominant player. Happy for his Hokies.
Apparently still doing some curls as well. Thomas looking for the deep ball after the turnover. Checks it down to Jay Edmonds in the flat. He gets to the 28. Kyle Fuller, senior from Baltimore, his 5th career interception. Older brother Vincent was a terrific defensive back for the Hokies. Played in the NFL. Corey Fuller was a wide receiver last year for the Hokies, and now the two brothers side by side, Kyle and Kendall.
Really, really good. And they're outstanding. At least today, both of them have been outstanding.
6.5 to go in the half. Slicing through, Sam Rogers, freshman walk-on fullback from Mechanicsville, Virginia. He got very close to the first down, down to the 25. They'll need a yard here on 3rd down.
Just interesting when a young guy gets in the ball game, is able to make a play. Sometimes your body and your mind get ahead of your feet. That's exactly what happened to Rogers.
Virginia Tech
tripped.
Just stumbling forward with some running room. So excited for his first career carry. Timeout Hokies. And 3rd down and 1.
Sean, I'm thinking this is a 4-down territory. It's tough to score in this Alabama defense. While you're down here, take your shots.
Out of the pistol, Logan Thomas keeps it. And it looks like he got enough for the first down. He did, to the 23-yard line before he got driven back. Vinay Patrick and C.J. Mosley the stop, but not before. It's a 1st down for Virginia Tech.
Not a bad idea to put the ball in the 6'6", 250-plus-pound Logan Thomas's hands. Let him dig for it with that long body.
The third first down for Virginia Tech. Alabama's had just five. This has been a defensive battle. Edmonds. Well, you have to like how quickly he attacks the hole, Chris, playing in his first game. There was no dancing through that hole. He hit it. Brandon Ivory made the tackle, but a quality gain of six on first down for Virginia Tech.
This looks to me like he's running to prove a point. One man's loss, another man's opportunity. J.C. Coleman with the ankle injuries. Edmonds said, give me my shot and take it. He did. Good job.
Tony Gregory injured. Fourth ACL injury. Michael Holmes thrown out of school. They don't have a lot of depth. That running back, late pitch. Edmonds did well to catch it. Actually got a half yard before he got walloped. Deion Blue up from the corner. Ed Stinson also in on the stop. Here's another big third down for the Hokies with under 5 minutes to go in the half. Third down and four.
What kind of an oxymoron is a physical corner? Well, Alabama has physical corners. They both come up and support the run. The toughness. Let's see if Alabama plays a little man-to-man. I wouldn't be surprised if Virginia Tech comes out in that little bit of a bunch formation with those crossing routes to help defeat the man coverage. The crossing route coming right there.
Whistle stopped the play. Don't see a flag, but there is one.
Delay game. Offense, number three. 5 yard penalty. Remains third down.
You have to have some awareness if you're Logan Thomas in this situation. Crucial third down. Get a TO.
Fourth penalty against the Hokies. They are in field goal range with a very good kicker, Cody Jurnell. Thomas blocks it up, and it is almost intercepted. Deion Blue had position. Dimitri Knowles able to prevent the interception.
Textbook corner play from both sides. Blue staying on the outside because he knows he has inside help. And look at him play the receiver, look and lean. Turn when the receiver's head turns. Logan Thomas maybe took a little off of that because of the forced throw early on by Xavier Dixon.
Cody Jurnell had a good year last year. 39 yard try from the right hash mark. And it is good right down the middle. Set up by the intercept, Virginia Tech 21-10. After the field goal by Jurnell, Mitchell Ludwig kicks off. Christian Jones from the seven. They didn't get him down. Touchdown, his second of the night. A punt return and now a kickoff return for a touchdown for Jones.
Sean, you know that's a dagger right in Frank Beamer's heart. He controls those special teams and they've let him down twice.
Over so many years they were known as the best special teams program in the country. That's where Beamer ball came from. The way they excelled on special teams, that is no longer the case in Blacksburg. You have to feel for the defense as the extra point is added by Foster. Alabama has 89 yards of offense in this half and leads 28-10. A 94-yard kickoff return for a touchdown, and it looked like Jones was down along the near numbers.
Well, the coverage isn't bad, but when you have the power and you do not wrap up players, and the power of Jones, Rogers had a chance at him, the true freshman fullback. But watch Jones, he'll just bounce off like he's not even there. They'll never quit on the play. They're Alabama Crimson Tide. Great effort is expected, and great effort is what you get.
And Christian Jones, second career kickoff return for a touchdown, his second touchdown of the night. took back a punt less than 2 minutes into the game for a score. The Alabama defense has scored, an interception return by Vinny Sunseri. They've scored just one offensive touchdown. Merrick Jones on special teams has almost doubled the output of the Alabama offense.
You can see there where the depth of Virginia Tech. You'd like to get some depth on those special teams, but they're so thin at a lot of positions that you're playing with players that maybe aren't ready to play at this level yet, and it's been proven. The punt return and the kickoff return.
Well, Frank Beamer might have been the first to really put almost all starters out on those special teams units. One of the reasons why they used to dominate. Darian Green elected to bring it out, and he got buried by Vinny Sunseri at the 15-yard line. Here's Reese Davis.
All right, Sean, it's time for Sports Center right now, brought to you by Ally Bank. Tim Tebow's run with the Patriots is over. The team releasing him today, subject to waivers. If he clears waivers, he'll be a free agent and can sign with any team. Johnny Manziel made his return in the second half. 3 touchdown passes. Got an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty, too, as the Aggies took care of Rice 52-31.
Here it's 28-10 for the number one team in the country, Alabama, which has next week off. And then in 2 weeks, they'll try to avenge their only loss of last season against Johnny Manziel and Texas A&M when they traveled down to College Station. Trey Edmonds was the ball carrier on first down for Virginia Tech, and he got a couple.
No matter what you think about Johnny Manziel, he has that it factor. Everybody wants that it factor. He has it. And you can just see the energy of the whole team change when he came on the field the second half today.
They struggled early in that game, trailed for a while. They led by 7 at the half, and he came in to play the second half. Dalvin Tomlinson brought down Edmonds. You wonder if Alabama will think about using its timeouts here. I would think if they stop him on this third down play,
absolutely,
they would.
Yeah.
All 3 timeouts left for the Crimson Tide. 3rd and 8 Hokies from their own 18.
And they're all playing man to man across the board. Good on good. And so far, the corners of Alabama have won their man coverage battles.
Logan Thomas is 3 for 13 for 40 yards and an interception. Pressure. And throws it away. And again, in fairness to Logan Thomas, Chris, you look at this wide receiver group for Virginia Tech. Who's the playmaker right now? You really can't identify anybody who is.
No, absolutely, Sean. And it's been proven because when you watch from the wide angle and you can see the whole field, there's no separation being created between the wide receivers of Virginia Tech or the secondary of Alabama. And so he has nowhere to throw.
Saw Aaron Moorhead, former NFL players, the new wide receiver coach, talking to Dimitri Knowles as he came off the field. 6th punt of the half for A.J. Hughes. And not a good one. Short and wobbly. With a good bounce. And finally down to the 34-yard line. A great opening weekend of college football continues Monday. Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week from Heinz Field. The Pittsburgh Panthers going to make their ACC debut when they host Florida State, ranked number 11. Seminoles and Panthers Monday night at 8. On ESPN, also live on Watch ESPN.
I expect Pitt to be improved under the second year of Paul Chryst. I know one thing, they're going to be physical. And Florida State's in for a street fight when they go to Pittsburgh.
Panthers were 6-7 under Paul Chryst last year. Pittsburgh and Syracuse moving into the ACC. This year in football, D. Hart. Flag down. He's down at the 35. Wrapped up by Luther Matty. The Hart bothered by a lot of knee injuries the last few years. Limited his playing time.
Holding offense number 71. 10-yard penalty, previous spot. Still first down.
Well, that should never happen. You know why? He's away from the play. So Quandre Cyrus, that's his second penalty of the night, shouldn't hold away from the play because it's not a factor. You got to be smarter than that, disciplined.
He's from Hyattsville, Maryland, out of Damatha Catholic High School. Family's from the African nation of Cameroon. Came to this country, to Maryland, when he was 4 years old. But for much of his youth, he was a soccer player. Dad played soccer with distinction in Cameroon. Eventually grew in to be a football player. Hart ahead to the 29-yard line. Kendall Fuller made the tackle. And the Hokies going to use their last time out of the half. We'll take advantage of the break to check back in with Reese Davis.
All right, Sean, Buick halftime reports just around the corner. Mark May and Lou Holtz will join me. Johnny Football is back and brought a little controversy with him. The Buckeyes were rolling easily, had a few little missteps along the way, and Notre Dame made their debut. Tommy Reese started strong, finished well also. Mark and Lou, plenty of highlights all coming up in the Buick halftime report.
Here, A.J. McCarron in Alabama, leading 28-10. You mentioned the chip on his shoulder. He admitted he had one, Chris, when we spoke with him the other day. He said, we want to prove the doubters wrong. I said, well, you got 58 out of 60 votes in the AP preseason poll. Doesn't seem like many people doubt you. Most are giving you credit. He said, well, because we've won a couple in a row, they feel like they have to pick us, but they don't really believe we're going to do it. I don't know how he knows that, but
I believe it. I think Coach Saban does a good job of training these guys to make them think certain things that he wants them to think.
Hart again.
A little surprised, Sean, that they went a conservative on this drive.
Well, their offense hasn't been very good.
No.
I think that's been the big negative of the half. No sustained offense to speak of, just 95 yards from scrimmage.
The only reason why I say that is because you want to get that 2 minute work in at game speed and game tempo anytime that you can.
I think Nick Saban's first thought here is he wants to win the game, and with the way the offense is playing, doesn't want to make the key mistake.
I can understand that with a 7-point lead, but with an 18 point lead, you might gamble just a tad.
I'm sure Nick will appreciate the suggestion if you want to send it down to him.
I will.
D. Hart, the ball carrier. And Virginia Tech can't stop the clock again. Only one offensive touchdown. The two scored by Christian Jones, a punt return, the kickoff return, and the defense brought one back for a score as well. And Alabama will get the second half kickoff. Leading 28-10 by just 96 yards of offense and five first downs for Alabama. Return, a punt return, and a kickoff return in the same game. Stanford, the last team to do it, against San Jose State in 2009. Mitchell Ludwig kicked off for the Hokies. Here's Christian Jones, and I think Frank Beamer might have read the special teams the riot act, as Jones barely made the 15-yard line. Here's Shannon Spake.
Well, I spoke with Nick Saban as he led his team out of that locker room just moments ago. And despite the numbers on the scoreboard, he told me he just doesn't feel that his team has played the way that they're supposed to play. Not enough intensity, not enough discipline for everyone to do their job. Specifically, I asked him about the offensive line. He said there are too many negative plays, too many missed blocks. So that is certainly an area where he is going to keep his eye this second half.
Not only miss blocks, Sean, but they have a lot of people up at that line of scrimmage, so they don't have enough blockers to block all the defenders for the Hokies.
You know, when you play Virginia Tech, they're going to have eight or nine up around the line. They get Yeldon free, and he's chopped out of bounds across the 40. They'll give him the 42-yard line for a 27-yard gain. They had only four rushes in the first half that went for more than 3 yards, Alabama.
Remember the first half when TJ got tackled by the 18-yard line? That was the exact same play. Ryan Kelly did a nice job of sealing Edwards, number 24, the middle linebacker, creating a hole for Yeldon.
12 rushes now for 49 yards. 7 of his 11 carries in the first half went for 2 yards or fewer. Dalston Fowler in at fullback. McCarron is sacked. Back at the 35-yard line. Second sack of the night for the Virginia Tech defense. Jack Tyler, who's been a standout again tonight.
Yeah, that's why we gave him the Impact Player Award at the beginning of the game, because we knew he would be. This is called a green dog. He has man-to-man coverage on Yeldon. So instead of playing man-to-man, once he sees Yeldon go to block, he becomes a fifth pass rusher. Bud Foster exactly wanted to do that coming into the game. Well executed by Jack Tyler.
And Bud Foster said he had all the respect in the world for McCarron, what he's done. So accurate in recent years, but he played behind the line that gave him all day to throw. That is not the case tonight. Had to set up a screen to Yeldon, and Hopkins wasn't going to allow it to happen. Derek blew that play up.
Well, when you're inside defensive lineman and you get a short set by your offensive lineman, and they're not giving any ground, you're able to read screen. As soon as the offensive lineman vacates, the rule is you get on his hip and chase him down the line of scrimmage. Again, execution, and I can't say enough about the performance of the two inside guys for Virginia Tech, Hopkins and Maddie. Big fellas.
Third and 17. Here comes a blitz. They set up a screen for Cooper, and he swung down. Good response by the defense. Tariq Edwards tackled Cooper.
You know, Sean, although Kyle Fuller did not make the play, he did his job by taking contain as a corner. You have to force the ball back inside, forcing Cooper to retreat and allowing the pursuit of the Hokie defense to clean up.
Cody Mandel to punt for the fourth time. And the true freshman Kendall Fuller goes back deep. Good kick. Fuller. Flagged down for a block in the back, and Fuller's down by Landon Collins, who's been a standout covering punts tonight for Alabama. 50-yard punt.
And another mistake on the special teams unit. With the offense that is struggling to move the football, you want to try to create some type of field position, and this is bad field position.
Bill Lamagne, it was mentioned many times in the past, terrific referee, but he usually has to talk to every member of his crew, it seems, before they...
Illegal block in the back on the return. Number 53. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Drew Burns called for the penalty. Back up linebacker. So it won't be good field position for Logan Thomas, and he doesn't have good stats. 3 for 14. An interception that was returned by Vinny Sunseri for a touchdown. And as we said a couple of times, Chris, in the first half, the crowd trying to make it difficult for him. Nobody in that wide receiver core that jumps out as a playmaker for him right now. Edmonds, big hole and a first down to get them out of that hole. See carry to the 17-yard line. John Fulton made the stop, over 100 yards in his first career game for Trey Edmonds.
Against the number one defense last year in Alabama. He didn't take advantage of his opportunity. You love to see that from a young player.
It's very rare to rush for 100 yards against the Crimson Tide defense. That was a gain of 12. He's up to 118. We're about coming into tonight's game, since 2008, the Alabama defense had allowed only 3 rushers to go for 100 yards or more against them. 3 since 2008. Far and away the best such number in the country. Timeout, Hokies. 3 minutes into the second half. BCS era, which began in 1998. Alabama trying to win its third straight national championship, trying to open its season with a win. Leading 28-10 here in the opening moments of the third quarter. On first and 10 for Virginia Tech, Trey Edmonds carries to the 24. Gain of six.
Sean, if you're Virginia Tech, you want to get Logan Thomas back on track. Okay, you have to first look at what Alabama's doing defensively. They're playing bump and run man-to-man coverage. You have to have some type of formation that are man beaters, so you want to run some pick routes, a little bit of a cluster formation, because there's no separation being created between the Virginia Tech receivers and the Alabama defensive backs. Example A.
Looked like he was trying to take it back from Edmonds, and Edmonds wasn't going to let him keep it. And it's a loss of three. Adrian Hubbard, and it's Stinson combined on the stop for the Tide.
Caught up a little bit in the land of confusion. Just to be safe, let me hold on to it.
Third down and five. Did just 2 out of 9 on third down tonight.
You see that tough man-to-man across the board.
38 combined points, only 10 combined first downs, and Thomas threw a sinker low and away.
You know, you're exactly right. He did throw a sinker low and away, but in fairness to Logan Thomas, there's nobody to throw the ball to. Everybody's covered.
Saw Jonathan McLaughlin, the left tackle there, the true freshman in his first game. Looked like he had a pretty good hold of the face mask of Adrian Hubbard on the rush.
He's done a nice job, though. He's holding his own tonight.
Christian Jones done a great job. Might be the national player of the week with punt return and a kickoff return for a touchdown. Hughes handled the low snap. Short punt, great bounce. But it came right up into the numbers of Jones. And he's to the 46-yard line, adding to his good night. Chuck Clark made the tackle for the Hokies. 48-yard punt, 16-yard return. Number one puppetry. A.J. McCarron on first and 10 from the 45. Trying to pull the string on a deep ball. Overthrew DeAndre Wright. We didn't know that our apparently these are from the son of the puppetry. Would you like to be me for a minute and say something really stupid?
No, I would like to say that I've always been wanting to do something to you for a very long time. There, maybe I can.
That is not very nice. That is not very nice. I'm Chris Spielman, and I really just want to go out and hit somebody right now on that field. They've got a lot of pent up aggression. I'm not sure I like the likeness.
You look good.
Yours looks a lot like you, but mine. Does Shannon have a puppet?
What do you guys
think? Mari Cooper. Oh, yeah, that's you.
I can't hold the mic and pull the string, but I've been dodging cars for a few years, and now I'm dodging receivers.
See,
what was that?
I didn't even notice the string. They literally surprised us with this and handed it to us during the break. I didn't know that if we pulled the string, the mouth moves.
Oh. I want to know how they knew I was going to wear purple today.
It's good.
Saban must feel this way. A lot of times he orchestrates just about everything that happens in the program.
He's in control, that's for sure. Your string doesn't work anymore after the violent hit you took.
Yeah, that was very violent. Third and six, McCarron, incomplete. The Virginia Tech defense holds again. Tended for Cooper's, had a frustrating night. And I think, even though they're ahead by 18, the Tide fans watching this are being a little concerned about the offense. Doesn't look good.
No, and I think if you would ask Nick Saban what's the problem or how would you break down this game so far, it's not clean. Mm-hmm. And right there, J.R. Collins for Virginia Tech, number 42, forced an early throw by McCarron, and he could not get his left foot going to the target. That's why the ball was low and away.
Like they might be coming after this punt. Nobody back deep for Virginia Tech. Mandel does get it off.
What? I don't agree with that, Sean. I think you have somebody back there worked out for him, but you want to save yards and save field position as much as you can.
Denzel Duvall downed it near the 18-yard line. Here's Reese.
All right, Sean. Remember a couple years ago, Oregon State started the season, lost to Sacramento State. Well, they're playing Eastern Washington, number 4 in FCS, and Eastern Washington's up. Vernon Adams hitting Cooper Kupp with a touchdown. It's 29-17 at halftime.
Wow. That's the big surprise last night. Perhaps not as big a surprise to some, including Lou Holtz, who called it. North Dakota State beating Kansas State. Edmund slipped as he took the handoff. John Fulton there for the Alabama defense.
They're starting to dial up a little bit of pressure, and it's tough to run when you cannot block a blitzing corner. And a lot of times you'll see that corner blitz when it's on the hash mark, because it's a short distance for a player like Fulton to go to close the gate. He's physical. I really like him at corner.
Alabama's won its last 11 season openers. Play action pass. Thomas, can he finally find somebody open? No, he stumbled as he went to dump it off for Edmonds. I don't know where the answers are going to come in terms of the wide receiver group for Virginia Tech. Just the good news, Chris, is after today, their schedule gets a lot easier. They're not going to be facing the Alabama defense. These receivers will have a better chance of getting open in the next 3 weeks. They play Western Carolina, East Carolina, and Marshall before they bounce into ACC play when they come back here to Atlanta to play Georgia Tech in less than a month. Thomas, one for his last 13. This is 3rd and 11. There's the deep ball, and it's batted away from Knowles by Deion Blue.
It's the same story. There's no separation being created by the Virginia Tech wide receivers, and actually a ball that maybe could have been caught. And Blue is able to maybe get that left hand in there to distract and deflect.
A.J. Hughes, his 8th punt. Christian Jones back deep. Average 47 yards per punt inside the dome here tonight. Fair catch signaled and made by Jones. Going to mark it near the 35-yard line. Well, Christian Jones is finding success tonight in special teams areas. Brought to you by Expedia. First score of the night. 72-yard punt return for a touchdown just a minute and 39 seconds in to make it 7-0 Alabama. And then he did it again with a kickoff return. The final score of the first half that made it 28-10. He went 94 yards when the Hokies thought they had him bottled up. Yeldon is the running back. Two tight ends for the Crimson Tide. TJ's ahead to the 38. He says it's his goal to be the best running back they've ever had, and they've had a steady stream of talent in recent years. Mark Ingram, Trent Richardson, Eddie Lacy. A lot of times the last 2 years they've worked in tandem. Last year, Lacy and Yeldon, a terrific duo. Looks like they're still trying to figure out who might be the guy to step in with some regularity behind Yeldon. Right now it's Alti Tenpenny, a true freshman. I believe they have some talented young people behind him. The game's been so tight, they've had Yeldon in there for most of it. And Tenpenny gets a rude welcome to college football. Gang tackled, led by Jack Tyler and Daddy Nicholas.
And the thing is that Virginia Tech is daring Alabama to throw the football. It's just a battle of wills. It's almost like Alabama's offense is being stubborn. They have one safety about 15 yards deep, both corners pressed, and 8 guys in the line of scrimmage. And they're refusing to challenge Virginia Tech. Now, it's going to come, but right now, they're playing right into Virginia Tech's hands, making it easy to defend a run.
3rd down and 11. Good protection from this new offensive line. And now McCarron running for his life and taken down from behind. Nigel Williams. Freshman from Richmond with the third sack of the night for Virginia Tech.
Actually, Virginia Tech is sitting in a zone right now, but the key is they don't cover just space. They're all jumping men, and by the time the guy broke open, Williams was there to close the deal on A.J. McCarron.
So Mandel punts again. Time they set up for return. Kendall Fuller hoping for a block, and he got one. Got one from his brother Kyle. And then the ball lowered the boom on his younger brother. Heavy hitting on both sides and all of it legal.
Oh, big brother protection. Can't get two though.
Landon Collins took the blow for Alabama and then the ball.
I think that's going to be a good game. I really do. Yeah. I think TCU is going to be ready.
Sniping back and forth in the press.
I like that.
Between the two schools already. Should be a spirited battle. Two schools that play great defense every year. Trey Edmonds back to the line, wrapped up by Jeffrey Pagan. Here's Shannon Spake.
Well, Sean, as you can imagine, it really is a tale of two games down here on the Virginia Tech sideline. You have the defense that is just full of energy and excitement. The offense, on the other hand, it's very calm over there. And watching Jeff Grimes, he's really calm when he's talking to his offensive line. And Frank Beamer had said that he wanted to use this game as a learning experience because it's such a great team to expose what they need to work on.
I don't think the offensive line's been a problem tonight. I think the offensive line has played pretty well.
There's just no threats in the receiver area. Going deep and nobody open. People stumbling and fumbling and no complete pass. Carlos Parker, they try a new guy, a true freshman, is trying to get deep, but he started stumbling around near midfield.
You know, their feet are going to get caught up, but again, you see the tight coverage. Not only by Virginia Tech, but these two corners from Alabama, outstanding all night.
There's a flag down on the near sideline near the 27-yard line, just past the line of scrimmage.
We have an ineligible receiver, number 18. He was covered downfield. That penalty's been declined. Third down.
Again, third and 10, Sean, if they line up man-to-man, you have to run some type of crossing route or pick routes. I have yet to see that. We saw that bunch formation in the first half. We have not seen that in the second half. That's what will help you create separation.
Only four first downs for the Hokies. 6 minutes to go, third quarter. Blitz on third and 9. Edmonds trying to run through it and can't. Cross the line, and that's all. Ed Stinson, the primary tackler. And another three and out for Virginia Tech. You know, they managed to rally late last year, Chris, won their last two regular season games to get the 6-6 and become bowl eligible for the 20th year in a row, and then won the bowl game against Rutgers. They had only 196 yards of offense and 13 points in an overtime win of the bowl game. They averaged 18.5 points per game their last six games last year. In a prolonged struggle, here's Christian Jones running the punt across midfield, swung down by Chuck Clark. Jones continues to have a big night, as does Reese Davis.
Sean, in the offseason, Mike Leach said the bottom of the Pac-12 was better than the bottom of the SEC, and here's the game to settle that dispute. Washington State against Auburn. Wazoo is up 7-0. Trey Mason scored for the Tigers. It's on ESPNU early second quarter. Gus Malzahn's team up by a single.
Interesting comment
from Mike Leach.
Oh yeah, they're always interesting.
I was going to say, he's an interesting guy. 19-yard punt return by Jones has McCarron in the offense in plus territory. After the sixth three and out of the night for Virginia Tech. McCarron just 9 out of 19 for 72 yards. Yeldon broke the tackle. And as the first down, it seems, Jack Tyler knocked him down from behind. And they are going to move the chains. First down, Alabama on a 10-yard run. Derek DiNardo coming off the field for the Hokie defense, backup linebacker.
And he had Yeldon knocked his helmet off. And again, one of the strengths of T.J. Yeldon, yards after contact, and ran right through the arms and helmet of DiNardo.
Second Yeldon tried to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage, but didn't get there. Tariq Edwards, Luther Matty blew up that play. And here are the numbers for Alabama last year. They had one of the best offensive seasons in school history, but way off those numbers tonight against this very good Virginia Tech defense.
It's almost like they're stubborn and saying, we're going to run the ball and we're going to run the ball. And I'm telling you, they'll be able to run it if they take some shots on first down, not second and long or third and long. Throwing the football.
Alabama last year set the school record for points scored in the season and for offensive touchdowns. Cooper, beautiful throw by McCarron, but Amari couldn't hang on. Feathered it in there nicely. Did the senior quarterback, Kyle Fuller, again in on the stop with help from the safety, Dietrich Bonner.
Kyle Fuller's making a name for himself. First of all, the athleticism with the hip flip, getting the arm right and raking the arms, then taking a shot from his own guy and Dietrich Bonner. Just the discipline to play the receiver, trust your training, and when the hands go up, take your right arm and swat the arms of the receiver. Just, I can't say enough about the kid, both guys.
Blitz coming. McCarron saw it coming. Here's the man open. Jones is in the end zone again. His third touchdown of the night, his first on offense. And if he's not the National Player of the Week, Chris, there must be somebody else somewhere else doing something very special.
He's been Alabama's offense tonight.
Cade Foster for the extra point, trying to make it 35-10. Christian Jones. A punt return for a touchdown, a kickoff return for a touchdown, and now a TD reception of 38 yards. Tie. Adam Griffith to kick off. Darian Green, Chris Mangus. Back to field it for the Hokies. This is Green, a freshman from Portsmouth, Virginia. Well, he did well to get across the 20. It looked like they might hem him in inside the 10.
Well, if you can't get Fuller, let's get Fry, number 26. If you're going to play man-to-man with no safety help, you cannot give a free release to the inside slot receiver. There's no contact, no disruption of the route. And when you have an explosive player like Christian Jones, you're putting yourself at a disadvantage at the snap of the football. You don't disrupt him, he's going to run right by you. He should know that. He's already had touchdown for a kickoff and a punt.
Logan Thomas, flag down. He takes off running. Has the first down if it stands. It looked like there was some movement on the Virginia Tech side.
Illegal motion, offense, number 18, 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
DJ Coles. Guilty of the penalty. Well, that's the night for Christian Jones. Three touchdowns. Two of them on special teams.
It's nice to have him coming off the bench on offense, isn't it, with the fresh legs? That's the depth that Alabama has at their skill positions.
Sixth penalty against the Hokies. Alabama's been flagged just twice. In the last 4 years, Alabama, the second least penalized team in the country. So good in so many areas, including those that involve discipline. A'shaun Robinson and Brandon Ivory put a pretty good pop on Edmonds. Only Navy has been penalized less Over the last 4 years in Alabama, Alabama doesn't turn it over. Last 54 games, Chris, entering tonight, 53 turnovers. Fewer than the turnover per game. The only team in the country that can make that claim over the last 4 years. When you don't turn it over, you're not penalized. You're going to win. Nice throw. One of the few times tonight, a man open. It's Joshua Stanford, highly touted freshman, with his first catch. Out of Mississauga, Ontario, just outside Toronto, 16-yard gain.
Well, this is what Logan Thomas is capable of. Again, knowing where the receivers are and able to dump it over a corner's head and in between a free safety. That's what he's capable of doing. The problem is, I don't know if he has the skill around him to do that on a consistent basis. At least we haven't seen it tonight.
Second career catch for Stanford. He played last year against Austin Peay. Had a catch. Had a knee injury, missed the rest of the year, given a medical red shirt. Edmonds ahead to the 44-yard line, 3 yards shy of the marker. We're under 2 minutes to go now in the third quarter, and Alabama leads by 25.
Just a note there on Edmonds. C.J. Mosley had him dead to rights in the hole. C.J.'s an All-American linebacker. Edmonds threw the spin move on him. C.J. throw a no-hitter.
Edmonds up to 132 yards rushing. They have just 197 yards of total offense. Thomas kept it. C.J. Mosley wrapped him up right at the line of scrimmage.
Like all great players do, miss a tackle, you make amends by getting a big 6'6" Logan on the ground.
Mosley said he thought about coming out in the NFL draft at the end of last year, meaning they would have had 10 players drafted. Decided to come back for a chance to win one more national championship, make history by helping his team win a third in a row.
A solid player, equally talented against the run and the pass.
Nick Saban hoping he'll step it up even more in the leadership area with this defense. Blitz. Thomas got it off, and it might be a first down. Dimitri Knowles tackled immediately by Mosley. They're going to give him the spot and a first down for the Hokies with a half minute to go in the quarter.
Well, that's exactly what we've been asking them to do, is to get in that bunch formation to beat the man and run crossing routes to pick off the defenders. And they're able to convert the first down. Good call by Scott Loeffler.
Loeffler, the offensive coordinator, raves about Logan Thomas. Said he's improved in the last 8 months more than any quarterback that he's ever been around. Loeffler's been around guys like Tom Brady when he was at Michigan, and Chad Henne, Tim Tebow when he was at Florida. Up for grabs, it goes, and it's incomplete. In the direction of Dimitri Knowles, Deion Blue had a better chance on the last play of the third quarter. This one touchdown in the quarter was scored by Alabama by Christian Jones. Thursday night, Georgia State was in here last night for its opener, lost to Samford. And now this neutral site game. Virginia Tech and Alabama. Frank Beamer might not want to play more of these neutral site openers. It's the fifth time they've opened at a neutral site game. They've lost the previous four. First play of the fourth quarter is Trey Edmonds getting spilled by Denzel DeBall right at the line of scrimmage. Third down and 10.
Sean, what's the message so far after three quarters that Alabama's given you?
I think the offensive line has a little work to do to become cohesive. You know, they did try to mix and match a little bit, try some players at different spots. I think as they settle in on this unit and give it more time, they clearly have talent. But Doug Nussmeier said he was worried about the communication, both verbal and nonverbal, along that offensive line. Thomas has time. Too high. Looking for Joshua Stanford. Haha, Clinton Dix had a chance for an interception.
Well, first of all, it starts with good protection. But we talked about C.J. Mosley being smart on a run in the pass. He gets enough depth and he forces the high throw by Logan Thomas by being in a proper position and underneath the crossing route. That's a smart linebacker understanding down and distance.
And answer the rest of your question. There's Jones again, who's touched the ball 7 times tonight and has 3 touchdowns. Short punt by A.J. Hughes, got a good bounce. I think part of it for the Alabama offense is that they're playing against a very good defensive team and a very well coached. Jones, of course, Julio plays his home games here in the Georgia Dome for the Falcons. They're going to open their season against each other. Falcons and the Saints, week from tomorrow in New Orleans.
Mark Ingram, those traps out of your ears. Nobody can't hear what anybody's saying.
In the stands tonight, 73,114, a sellout. DJ Yeldon. Banged out of bounds near the 25. Here's Reese Davis.
John, time for SportsCenter right now, brought to you by Ally Bank. Patriots released Tim Tebow. Tim struggled for much of the preseason. Now, he clears waivers, he'll be a free agent and eligible to sign with any team that chooses to sign him. Johnny Manziel made his return in the second half against Rice. Hit 6 of 8 for 3 touchdowns. Also got an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. SportsCenter's on ESPN News. It'll roll around 10 Eastern.
We look forward to it. Might say it was a signature win for Texas A&M today. Or you might not. Yeldon finally getting some running room. Possible this defense would be getting a bit tired. Tyrell Wilson made the stop, a gain of 8.
They're playing a lot of plays. See the offense of Virginia Tech, the only thing that they provided is a lot of 3 and outs for this defense.
Do you think, given what happened with Johnny Manziel, the credibility of the NCAA, at least as a disciplinary organization, is now at just about an all-time low? I can't imagine how it could be any lower.
Well, I think a lot of people would think that. Again, I'm not privy to all
of everything else.
Yeah, and you know, it certainly looks like he's guilty. But if you know, you got to trust what they say and what they find. They have all the information. You know, you got to remember too that the NCAA is the rule enforcers. They don't make the law; they just enforce the law.
Interesting point. What would you tell Johnny if you were his coach?
I would do what our colleague or Bill Curry would do, or Herm Edwards. I'd bring him in the office and say, "Tell me the truth. Mm-hmm. Did you give money for signing these autographs? And if you did, then we got to protect the players on this team that didn't break the rules, and you have to sit out."
McCarron's pass juggled and incomplete. We're getting some of the young people in. The previous carry was by Derrick Henry, considered the top running back recruit in the country out of Florida. And then that was intended for O.J. Howard, who's a true freshman tight end and another 5-star recruit in this loaded true freshman class for Alabama.
And about another 6 games, O.J. Howard will bring that in. And a point to make right there is the efficiency and the accuracy of A.J. McCarron throwing a deep ball. He's outstanding. Completed 65% or 20 yards or more last year. And he'll be on pace to do that again this year.
McCarron just dumps it off, threw it away as he was under pressure. And they're going to flag him now for intentional grounding after some consideration by the officials. Wanted to make sure they got it right.
Now you see the conversation between Henry and McCarron. I guarantee you a true
intentional
freshman.
Grounding. Number 10 in the offense. Spot foul. Lost it down. 4th down.
Is being taught about pass protection. A.J. McCarron was telling him where you need to protect, because that's where a lot of true freshman running backs come in, as they struggle in pass protection.
Henry, the all-time leader in high school football and career rushing yards, more than 12,000 yards, Yulee High School in Florida, over 4,200 yards alone last year.
Slowed by the injury.
Fractured leg in the spring, didn't play in the spring game. Mandel got it off. Tyshawn Jarrett tackled immediately. Well, the Alabama special teams for the most part have been outstanding. Landon Collins the tackle. 12 minutes to go here in Atlanta. Touchdowns. That is 31 fewer than any other team in the country. Those are some great defenses on that graphic beyond Alabama. That is a remarkable number. Defense puts heat on Logan Thomas, who's looking for DJ Coles.
DJ Coles was looking to get hit and took his eye off the ball. That's the second time tonight. And that ball was right there, right on target. They really have to address that receiver position if they want to compete for an ACC title. They really have to address it because it's bad right now.
Good news is their schedule is very easy. They don't have another ranked opponent on their schedule, Virginia Tech, as of right now. It's a chance that some ACC teams could move into the rankings. There's another drop ball by DJ Coles. Had an awful night. Mentioned the non-conference schedule, three more games. They'll be favored in all three of them, and then they jump into ACC play. But as you can see, they don't play Florida State.
Clemson's not on that list.
Mm-hmm. Two teams that are in the top 11 in the country right now. I think at some point Miami's going to move into the rankings. That's a program moving back in the right direction under Al Golden.
Agreed.
Third down and 10. Thomas managed to stay on his feet and got it off in time for another drop. This one in the flat. Xavier Dixon applied the pressure that time. Logan Thomas is 5 for 25 passing tonight for 59 yards and an interception.
And to be fair, I mean, there's some passes that he's missed, but there's also times where there's no separation created. He has no targets to throw to. In just this last series, we saw three drops where the ball was on target.
Alabama giving some other people a chance to participate. D. Hart now back for the punt. And he's smothered immediately by Chuck Clark, who's had a good night covering kicks. That was the 11th punt of the night for Hughes after the 8th Korean NASCAR legend Shannon Spake, part of our broadcast team tonight. Delighted to welcome her to our team this year. And Derrick Henry stopped at the line of scrimmage of Shannon. And these two coaches, we have a couple of men who love them some NASCAR.
That's right, Sean. I mean, you really can't walk 5 feet in the NASCAR garage without running into a fan of either Virginia Tech or Alabama. And Frank Beamer, Nick Saban, they share their appreciation of the sport. Coach Beamer has been to many races. He's been in the pace car. Nick Saban has also been to Talladega. A.J. McCarron drove the pace car at Talladega. And some of the guys, I know they wanted to come out here and come to the game, but because of practice schedules, were not able to make it. But you know that they are watching over there at the Atlanta Motor Speedway.
Shannon's done a great job. She's usually used to talking when in the background. Intended for Ramari Cooper is the pass by A.J. McCarron.
It's a bit a little frustrating for Amari Cooper tonight. Had a few drops, and to be honest with you, you have a pest in a good way, like Kyle Fuller all over you. You know, they have some work to do on the practice field. And we talked about the Virginia Tech wide receivers. The wide receivers from Alabama haven't exactly created a lot of separation themselves this evening, and that's a vulnerability.
Playing against a good secondary, but there has been a lot of talk in this preseason that this Alabama receiving group might be the deepest and most talented they've ever had. D. Hart on the draw. He got stood up by Kyle Fuller, who's been tremendous tonight for the Hokies. This defense has still just given up 166 yards of offense to Alabama.
A lot of talk about the targeting rule. Well, this is how not to target. Head up, wrap up, and stay off the opponent's head. You'll never get a penalty called against you. That's just excellent form tackling. And again, Kyle Fuller showing his toughness at the corner position. He's been outstanding tonight. That's my new favorite player on defense, at least for this week.
Cody Mandel, the punt. Wow. That was a shot out of a cannon. Tyshawn Jarrett. Got a good block. No flags down. And he's wrestled down by the punter, Mandel. On the far sideline, I think the Hokies thought there should have been a face mask tacked on to the end of that as well. I was going to say it looked like he out-kicked his coverage, but there were Alabama players down there in coverage. They just couldn't get Jarrett.
Yeah, rule one, you never want to give up containing. It's that little move right there. Gets the contain or the outside defender sucked in, allowing the sidelines open for Jarrett. Mandel with a punter throwing a little nasty on him. Even the punters are good tacklers at Alabama.
61-yard punt, 43-yard return. Excellent field position for the Hokies, down by 25 with under 10 minutes to go. Pistol now for Thomas. Blitz off the corner. And Edmonds ahead. He's getting plenty of work in his first college game. Just 20th carry of the night for 132 yards and that long touchdown.
You know what I wouldn't mind seeing from Virginia Tech? Maybe to go a little bit of tempo or hurry up. Again, just to get work and reps in against a fine defense.
And if you're holding on any hope at all of
right,
winning
exactly.
the game,
you gotta go.
Still time would be borderline miraculous, but stranger things have happened. Under center for one of the few times. Thomas steps into the throw. And it's dropped by Knowles. Wow. I mean, Thomas is going to have one of the worst statistical nights you could ever see at this level for a quarterback. 5 for 26. But when you watch this receiving core, it's not all that surprising. And as you said, it's not that he's been outstanding, but he's certainly been a lot better than those numbers would suggest.
I think he's doing a pretty darn good job because he's throwing a lot of catchable balls. And frankly, his teammates have let him down.
Third down and 9. Four-man rush, and they get there. Thomas, so strong, managed to stay on his feet for a while. He battled all the way to the end of that play. Xavier Dixon, primary man involved in the first sack of the night for Alabama.
Yeah, you see big Xavier Dixon doing a flip over Logan Thomas, and testimony to the strength the lower body of Logan Thomas doing his best Ben Roethlisberger impersonation. He's going to be okay. I think Logan Thomas is loaded with potential. He just has to live to it, and I think he's getting closer to living that potential that led to his projection of the number one draft pick last year, before the start of last year.
The 12th punt of the night for A.J. Hughes. Down by Tyler at the 10. Here's Reese.
Sean, on ESPNU, Washington State and Auburn are going back and forth. This is Corey Grant of Auburn. I'm sure that name is familiar to Alabama people because he is the Alabama transfer to Auburn. Corey Grant scoring the touchdown. Tigers on top, 22-21.
Maurice, thank you. New quarterback now for Alabama. Blake Sims, a bit of competition in the preseason to see who would be the backup. Sims wanted limited playing time behind McCarron last year, more of a running threat than McCarron. There's Tenpenny, Alti Tenpenny, true freshman from North Little Rock, Arkansas, run out by fellow true freshman Kendall Fuller. At the 30, 20-yard gain. And Chris, not a big night statistically for A.J. McCarron, who's been billed as a Heisman Trophy candidate, and understandably so, with his resume entering the season, just 10 for 23 for a touchdown and an interception, 110 yards.
Really one bad pass by A.J. was the interception by Kyle Fuller. But other than that, I think A.J. was suffered from a little bit of the drops by his wide receivers.
A little more pressure than he's accustomed to behind this remade offensive line, losing three stalwarts off that team that won the championship last year. Tenpenny taken down by Derek DiNardo, about a yard and a half short of another first down. Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week continues tonight at 9 o'clock on ESPN. SEC Big 12 matchup number 12 LSU takes on 20th ranked TCU. Presented by Hampton Hotels on ESPN, 9 o'clock tonight, also live on Watch ESPN. So less than a half hour away from the start of that game. We're told the kickoff will be at 9:11. You want to take a nap for a half hour or so, get up at 9:10. Jack Tyler, another tackle. He's on Tenpenny.
He's a good player, too. Mm-hmm. I'm really impressed, Sean, with the performance of the Hokie defense. And frankly, I don't know why I'm surprised. They're well coached under Bud Foster, 9 returning starters, and they play with great effort.
Third down and 1. The Hart slices across the left side of the line to the 44 for another first down. Well, we mentioned 8 straight seasons, Chris, of 10 wins or more for Virginia Tech. Streak that ended last year, they went 7-6. They were the only team in the country that won at least 10 games over that 8-year stretch. If they have another so-so year, you start to fight the perception battle, all the program slipping, and then they'll be talking about Frank Beamer's in his late 60s, and maybe it's time to consider a change.
Well, I think Frank Beamer's earned the right to be there as long as he wants to be there.
Sims runs out of bounds. Well, he is most certainly going to be in the Hall of Fame. Both of these coaches are locks, and there's no way that you could keep either one of these two coaches out of the Hall of Fame, which is moving here to Atlanta. Will open in the fall of 2014. Prior to Frank Beamer, they won 53% of their games. Under Frank, more than 67. 10 wins in 13 of the last 17 years. If you think about after 6 years, Chris, he was 24-40-1. In his 6th year, they went 2-8-1. A lot of people calling for his head. And a lot of us never would have heard of him. Dave Brain was the athletic director. He believed in him. He gave him another chance. They went 9-2 the next year. And started 20 straight winning seasons in Blacksburg. One of the great coaches of his time. The winningest coach in the country right now with 258 wins.
You know, if you look at it and from analyzing this football team, and we've said it all night, they need to upgrade their recruiting as far as skill positions. They're not very talented at the skill positions. Obviously, their offensive line has held up well tonight. The true freshman McLaughlin has played excellent for a true freshman. The defense is the typical Virginia Tech defense. Where they're lacking is the skill positions on offense.
And they've lost some people due to injury and for disciplinary reasons at the skill position. Sims yanked down by Deion Clark. Luther Matty, who's still in there at defensive tackle, and Alabama, after crossing midfield, will punt with under 5 minutes to go. Virginia Tech has dressed 29 freshmen tonight. They're true freshmen or redshirt freshmen. Very high number, and Frank Beamer does believe there is a lot of talent in that freshman class. Certainly seen it tonight from Kendall Fuller. Mandel punting for the 9th time. Still only 17 first downs combined. Fair catch made by Tyshawn Jarrett at the 9-yard line. ESPN. New quarterback is in, Mark Leal, in for Logan Thomas, and a flag before they can snap it.
Illegal substitution. Defense, 12 men in position. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
You know, they're good enough with 11. You don't have to cheat like that.
You know, you think about it, Sean, besides that 178-yard run, it's been very, very good, and as good as advertised coming into this game, yeah. Especially in the back end. And really impressed with the corner position, which Nick had a little bit of question about, and see how the guys would respond, and I would say they passed the test with flying colors tonight.
Offensive line and defensive backfield seem to be the two biggest questions. There's Leal, a junior, Green Acres, Florida. Chris Mangus carries. Here's the busiest man this weekend in college football. Reese Davis back in the studio. Reese.
It is a labor of love, Sean. Georgia and Clemson on ABC. Taj Boyd just put the Tigers up 7-0. First play after that from scrimmage for the Dogs. There goes Gurley. Todd Gurley, 75 yards. He houses it. 7-7, Dogs and Tigers. Still fairly early in the first on ABC.
Thank you, Reese. Reese did the play-by-play of the big game Thursday night, South Carolina. Obviously in the studio tonight. Very astute observation on my part. And he'll be doing the play-by-play for the game we just mentioned, Florida State and Pittsburgh, Monday night.
A man of great endurance.
Yes. But he has to live up to that enormous paycheck. Here's a look at tonight's Good Hands Play, brought to you by Allstate. Why wouldn't it be Christian Jones? After a couple of special teams touchdowns, a punt return, and a kickoff return for a touchdown, he caught a touchdown pass of 38 yards from A.J. McCarron. Good Hands Play brought to you by Allstate. 7 touches, 3 of them taken to the end zone by Jones, the junior. Leal hands it off. Mangus got flattened by another true freshman, Jonathan Allen. Well, we mentioned Virginia Tech's schedule hereafter is favorable, and it really is true for Alabama as well. They have the much anticipated game in 2 weeks against A&M as they try to avenge last season's only defeat. But then you look down, you don't see another number next to an opponent, number 12, LSU. No Georgia in the regular season. No Florida, no South Carolina.
Imagine they'll be a double-digit favorite in most of those games.
Well, we're told probably every one of those, except the Texas A&M game coming up in 2 weeks. Nick Saban said he really wasn't thrilled to have that off week. Some might say you have the extra week to work out some of the problems that you saw here tonight and get ready for that one, but he'd rather just go ahead and play. What about Texas A&M? You had a chance to watch a little bit of them today. They'd like to think they're a national championship contender. Do you think so?
Well, I don't think so, because I think they struggle a little bit on defense. Now, if they can improve defensively with Johnny Manziel and an explosive offense, anything can happen. But in order for them to get into that conversation, they have to improve on the defensive side of the ball.
Well, most believe primary threat to the throne for Alabama is your alma mater, Ohio State. Looked good in spots today, had a couple of bad moments, some turnovers that were costly, particularly early in that game. They got one first place vote in the preseason AP poll. Georgia got the other of the two that did not go to Alabama, which got 58. By the way, 5 times there's been a team that got 50 or more first place votes in the AP preseason poll, and the team that got the 50 or more has not won the national championship once, so it's not necessarily a good omen. To me, your alma mater has a lot to prove. I know they were undefeated last year, but sneaked by in a lot of games against lesser foes. And I'm not a believer yet.
Well,
I think they have a shot.
Yeah. Well, I don't think Urban Meyer is a believer yet. Mm-hmm. They have to still prove it, and they have to get better, and their defense struggled at times. And they're a team that usually gets better defensively. And you talk about Alabama, and there's some issues. I mean, he's going to look at this game like I look at it, and like a lot of people will, that it wasn't clean, it wasn't efficient. Defensively, they're fine, but they're a team, Sean, when he's leading a football team, they will get better each week. And I think, although he said he didn't want that week off between the Texas A&M game, I think he's going to welcome the weekend just so maybe they can get a little extra work in, especially on the offensive side of the ball. But if you're a Nick Saban coach team, the one thing you can count on if you're an Alabama fan, they will get better each week. Well, the other team that I like, Sean, is Johnny Manziel in this game last year.
The only blemish on Alabama's record last season, November 10th. Johnny Manziel led number 15 A&M to the upset, 29-24. Ryan Swope, 10-yard touchdown at the time, gave the Aggies a 14-0 lead. Obviously, that was a huge resume booster for Manziel and his Heisman Trophy candidacy.
Two teams I like is Stanford and Oregon. Mm-hmm. Both of them are very talented. Stanford has an excellent front seven on defense. They're an old-school offense. Everybody knows how explosive Oregon's offense is. But the thing that is going to make them better is that I believe the Pac-12 is much improved from top to bottom. And so they'll get battle tested as the season goes on. And Georgia, if Georgia can hang on against Clemson tonight, it's a big statement.
By the way, the punt by A.J. Hughes a moment ago was his 13th of the night. That's one shy of the Virginia Tech single game record, a record he does not want to break. He has to punt again. He'll probably be right leg this time. That left leg has to be just about worn out. Tenpenny will get the last touch of the night. And it's another season opening win for Alabama. 12th in a row for the Crimson Tide. They win 35-10 despite the fact they had just 207 yards of offense. They held Virginia Tech to 212, and 78 of those Hokie yards came on one play. Virginia Tech just 7 first downs, the offensive struggles of a year ago carrying over against the best team in the country, Frank.